Hi, YouTubers. Thank you very much for taking your time to join me. They finally got the live web camera up and running for Old Faithful, but it's going stop and go, stop and go. Yeah, broken up a little bit. Not a very smooth frame of viewing, but at least it's going. So here's what's going on with Yellowstone. The largest earthquake they've had in the last day was a magnitude 3.3, but it was actually a 3.5. Six people said that they did feel this earthquake. USGS gave an intensity level of 3, probably because the reports that came in were quite a ways, or a little bit a ways, from where it happened. All right, so we got one here at Stanley. Intensity level 2, that was 27 kilometers southeast. So that would be about 16 miles. The other, also from Stanley, 52 kilometers east, about 32 miles, again, east, intensity level 3. Now by Cadwell, intensity level 3, southwest. So that would be about 87 miles. And then Nampa, which is 137 kilometers also, intensity level 3. So that would be about 87 miles. And again, intensity level 3. More than likely closer to the area of the earthquake, there would have been rock slides, I imagine. And you can see here we got 5 and 5.5 for a magnitude. Everyone runs outdoors. Damage to building varies depending on the quality of construction noticed by drivers of automobiles. And if there was any type of buildings close to that area, which there wasn't, panel walls would have been thrown down. Fall of monuments, walls, chimneys, sandbar ejections, and automobiles would have been disturbed. But they gave it a 3, which means it was felt indoors noticeably, but not always recognized as an earthquake. Standing autumns would have been rocking slightly, vibration like a passing truck. For some reason, I cannot get my Google Earth to work. So if we zoom in, you can see there's earthquake.gov. There is a road close to here, or a highway, Highway 21. We got Banner Creek, Bench Creek, and then, well, this one's also labeled Highway 21 also, but there's no construction that I can see on their map. It was a shallow earthquake, only 6.2 miles. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. And there is 104 earthquakes listed on this map, but that would include this one up here in Montana. Now, if I move the map, let's bring it down. Yeah, towards Salt Lake City, we got 126 earthquakes within the last week. Yeah, I gotta check out what's going on there in Salt Lake City. Now it jumped to 127. Yeah, the Wasatch Fault Zone looks like it's getting a little active. So here's that earthquake, and I'll bring it down. It was actually a magnitude 3.54. And you can see there's lots of them marked in red here. Also today, there was a magnitude 2.6 by Chalice, Idaho. I zoomed in a little bit here. Looking for the larger ones. A 1.4, yeah. Madison River area. A 2.3. That was yesterday. And let's see here. Bring it down. A 2.2, again, the Madison River area. A 2.4. Both of those were on the 13th. Then a 1.7 on the 15th. That was only 3.5 miles in depth. A 2.4 also on the 15th. A 2.3, that would have been Sunday. Let's see here. A 2.6, that was yesterday, Monday. Oh, that's Chalice, Idaho. Okay, along the, see, this is the Snake River Plateau here. And what else? And that's about it for the larger ones. All right, let's jump over to Little West Thumb. This one here at 434, marked in red, they're not reporting. Thought I'd take a peek what's going on here. We can see, yeah, magma coming in. Let's take a look at its signature. Oh, let's see what that one is. Yeah, we got screaming. Let's go to the seismic signature. Yeah, we got screaming today at Little West Thumb. Now remember, screaming is when it comes in so fast that the monitor can't pick it up. Now that was at 14:23 Universal Time, 9:23 a.m. Central Daylight Time. So this one that they're not reporting, that would have been at 11:33 p.m. last night. And let's see how large it is. That one comes in as a magnitude 1.83. We'll go back to the spectrogram. All right, and then the other one, marked in red, this one right here, at 4:11. That one comes in as a magnitude 1.52. That one, too, they're not reporting. That would have been 10:11 their time. And then yesterday, there's a whole series here. Oh, look at that. Yep, harmonic tremors. This would have been yesterday, 17:49. About 12:49 p.m., 12:50 in the afternoon. Yeah, look at that. Yeah, this would have been yesterday. Yeah, there's a whole series here. Look at that. Yeah, harmonic tremors. Again, this is Little West Thumb. All right, let's jump over to Soda Butte, which is in the northeast corner of the park. And you can see we got three lines of melt, possibly four lines of melt right there. This is what it was showing when I pulled the files. You can see two. And let's go up over here. Yeah, they probably got dike intrusion going on. Only one marked in red. Oh, look at that. See that? You should be able to recognize that signature. Let's go to its signature. Got so loud, it wouldn't pick it up. The machine wouldn't pick it up. Let's make that bigger. Yeah, that's harmonic tremors. Yep, very concerning. Now, this would be a location, probably the northeast section of the outside of the caldera itself, the wall of the caldera. Yeah, that's why, another reason I think it's concerning. Now we know that the magma chamber, the magma, the conduit, is moving northeast. So it could be an indication that we got, spreading in that direction. That would have been at 7:44 a.m. there at the park today. All right, 16:51, this would have been yesterday. You can see the signature there that I talk about. Let's look at the spectrogram. Let's go back to the signature. Let's make that bigger. 16:51. That would have been at 10:51 a.m. yesterday. Let me see if I can see anything else. It looks like another 16:03. But you can see here, for some reason, it shows it, but it didn't pull the data where I can click on it. I don't know. And I can't make that bigger to show it to you. There's a lot of popping of the rock as the pressure grows. You can see that here. I'm just kind of jumping around and looking at it. Yeah. This one's actually marked in, oops, is it there? Nope, right there. Actually marked in red. I'll make that bigger. Let's see here. Okay, there you go. Yeah, it's as big as I can get it. All right, the western boundary, which is the western entrance by Haugen Lake there. And yeah, there's quite a few here marked in red too. That one there is the 3.5, which they claim is a 3.3. And we got, yeah, it's interesting how it just kind of stopped there, and then we got smaller earthquakes here afterwards with this here. Yeah, the line of melt, if you remember my last report about this area. Yeah, we got it pretty darn close up there. This is what it was showing when I pulled the files. I'll just kind of jump around here. You see it's a little brighter there. Let's see, let's go to this little thing. Yeah. We'll pull it over a little bit. Oh, I wanted to go back there. There we go. Yeah, you can see we got three. Yeah, it's probably dike intrusion in these different locations. Let's go to this one here. Yeah. Yeah, the borehole, of course, is not working. So we got that to deal with also. Yeah. There's that little bit of activity at 10:26 universal time. That would have been 4:25 a.m. And yeah, let's go to the seismic signature of this stuff. This looks like all tectonic here, which I'm not surprised. Yeah, we know the plates are moving as the Earth magnetic field weakens. Let's go back to this little one. Yeah. Oh, good timing. Old Faithful's going off. Yep, it looks dirty. Look how dirty that is. Good timing. So what do you guys think? Yeah. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you very much for your support. Please like and share. And that's all I have for you for today. I'm always watching, as you know. Please stay safe. Keep prepping. And I will talk to you later. God bless y'all.